This is The Malice Code, a Remi Laurent FBI suspense thriller, Book 3, written by Ava Strong, narrated by Kevin E. Green. Prologue. The Church of St. Augustine, Rome, 7:45 p.m. Gareth Jax considered himself a hunter. While many younger men would chuckle to hear the portly, bespectacled man of 50 call himself such, especially since he had never stalked game or even held a gun, Gareth felt the comparison was more than appropriate. For he didn't hunt animals, he hunted knowledge. He was one of the best in the business, and he only went after big game. Gareth had been all over the world, delving into old books and hidden byways of knowledge. From the medieval Coptic monasteries of Egypt to the great universities of Europe, from the Library of Congress to the family manuscript collections of Timbuktu, Gareth Jax had made a study of some of the most obscure and difficult works to uncover the rarest of knowledge. But at the moment, he had to admit he was stumped. The church library had some of the rarest works of early medieval theology anywhere. Because the Church of St. Augustine dated back to the 8th century, making it one of Rome's oldest, and was run by the Benedictine order, it had kept its ancient library separate from that of the Vatican. There were books here that could be found nowhere else. So far, that hadn't made any difference. Gareth had been sitting in the vaulted reading room at one end of the basement chapel for 2 weeks now, straining his eyes as he read the tiny, faded Latin handwriting of long-dead scribes, hoping to come across what he sought. He hadn't. For 14 days, while above him tourists in their tens of thousands wandered the streets of Rome, taking pictures and eating gelato, he had sat alone in the cold stone vaulted cellar, searching. At first he had been thrilled, reading through 6th- and 7th-century sermons preached against the heresies of a Catholic church, still forming its ideology and trying to find its way. He had worked patiently, steadily, hunting down obscure references and cryptic hints, hoping to find a reference to what he sought. He had found nothing. At least not anything direct. Some mention the book, but since it had already been declared a heresy, no writing said anything about its contents, or if any copies had been preserved. On the contrary, a couple of scribes wrote about how caches of the book were found and used as kindling when their owners were burned at the stake. As one writer declared in a manuscript from 681 AD, "Thank Almighty God every one of the copies of the accursed text have been consigned to the pyre. No copy has been found in the hands of heretics for a generation or more." Gareth did not believe that. He did not believe that such an important, potentially earth-shattering book could be lost for all time. He had found far too many so-called lost texts to ever give up once he had started a hunt. He would have bet his entire personal fortune that a copy existed in the secret Vatican library, where the church kept its most controversial documents, but it might as well have been used to burn a medieval heretic. That collection was as far out of reach for someone like him as the moon. Even most cardinals and archbishops were refused entry. Given his background and associations, Gareth Jax couldn't even get into the public tourist areas of the Vatican without a fake ID. The church wouldn't let someone with his knowledge pass the gates of Vatican City. At least the Benedictines were understanding enough to let him use their library. The Opus Dei and some of the other conservative factions wouldn't even answer his emails. Gareth absent-mindedly pushed up the sleeve of his left arm and scratched the inside of his wrist, where the letter P was tattooed in the Gothic style. It was a habit of his when deep in thought, but he only did it when he was alone. A soft step echoing through the cellar's chill interior made him quickly pull down his sleeve and turn. Brother Luca was lighting candles in front of the icons of the Virgin Mary, Saint Benedict, and Saint Augustine at the far end of the room. His dark blue robes matched the sombre tones the painter had used for the icons.
"It is late, Signor Jax," the monk said in Italian when he saw him looking.
Gareth rubbed his tired eyes.
"Yes," he sighed.
Suddenly he realised he was hungry, and his back hurt, and his neck. 12 hours hunched over medieval manuscripts took a toll on the body, especially the eyes.
A nice pasta dish and a carafe of wine would take care of that. Then relaxing in his hotel room with Beethoven playing through his phone before an early night. First thing tomorrow morning he'd be fresh and ready for the chase. Gareth rose, stretched and packed up his notes in his leather briefcase.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.